Hello everyone, today we are going to design a circular water tank. So here it is an overhead water tank and the capacity we have to design is for 150 kiloliters. The first step is size of water tank members. So nothing is given, we have to assume first few things so that we can go for next steps. So here this is the circular water tank that we are going to design. So this is a ring beam B1, this is top dome, bottom dome, these are vertical walls. So we are going to design in this whole problem. So first is we have to going to design top dome, second we have to design the top ring beam B1, third we are going to design vertical wall, then we'll be designing the bottom dome, and at last this circular ring, okay, ring beam B2. So coming to the first step, size of water tank, I have assumed H1, the rise of top bottom top dome is 1.5 meter and this as 1.2 meter. Thickness of all these walls and this domes I have taken 100 mm, diameter I have taken here 10 meter, okay. On freeboard is 150 mm. Now as capacity is given 150 kiloliter, we are going to calculate the volume of cylinder. So the capacity means the water till this is the capacity, that means this much volume is the water, so that much should be 150 kiloliter. So how can we equate it? Means total volume cylinder is this, right, minus this area, this bottom dome area. If I reduce it, I'll take out, then I'll get the capacity of the tank, right? So first is V1, I have calculated as volume cylindrical part, pi by 4 d square, H3 I have taken because this whole is H3. So this whole volume minus this. So second part is volume of bottom dome. So this is pi R2 square, pi H2 square, R2 minus H2 by 3. So coming to this bottom dome, this B2, this part, okay, H2 rise and this part. So for this, this is the diameter D I have taken. If I'm going to take the radius of this, because this is like a sphere, right? This is, so this is like arc equation if I put, and this is the center O, this is R2 radius. So the formula, if you might have studied, H2 by 2 R2 minus H2 is equal to this span, or you can say D by 2 whole square. So from this I'll get R2. Okay, this radius how much for this dome. Now capacity of tank is given 150 kiloliter, which is also equal to 150 meter cube, because 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. Now volume of tank is volume cylinder minus volume bottom dome, this I have said now. So volume of cylinder is pi by 4 d square H3. So I'm just putting these values, minus pi H2 square, R2 minus H2 by 3 is equal to 150. So here diameter is given, we have assumed 10. And this R2 is again related to H2 in this equation. And you can see D is also given 10 meter. I'm going to put all these values. The only unknown is H3. So this is the this. So what I'm doing, this was the freeboard, this is the height, H3 I'm going to calculate, and volume of tank is this shaded part. So total volume cylinder minus this bottom dome volume is equal to 115. So I'm getting 2.52. So I've approximated to 2.55 meters. So let's take this as 2.55 meter. Next is we're going to design every members. So first start, let's start with design of top dome. Okay, this is the top dome. H1 is the rise. So this we have assumed H1 rise is 1.5 meter. If you see here, right, this one I'm going to now design. H1 I have assumed 1.5 meter. Okay. So if this is the H1, for this also radius using same arc equation, I'm getting this is 9 meter. Okay, now calculating the dead load of the top dome, because thickness is 100 mm in meter is 0.1 meter. 25 is unit weight of RCC, so 2.5 kilometer per meter square. Live load, I have taken 1.5 kilometer per meter square. So you can refer live loads in, like this live load we can use if there is some maintenance or some people are moving here for access is there. So we may need, because ventilator is here, right? So for any maintenance or anything, we may need some live load may come to this dome. That's why we have assumed to 1.5 kilometer per meter square live load. So total load is 2.5 plus 1.5, 4 kilometer per meter square. Now maximum meridional thrust. This formula is WR2. So this is R1 because this I have taken as R1. R1 by 1 plus cos alpha. This is the angle. So if I take this, 2 alpha is the inclination. Alpha means this triangle. Half this is, so sine alpha will be d by 2 perpendicular by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is r2, so 5 by 9 because this is 10 meters, so 10 by 2, 5 by 9 we have calculated the radius. So this is our angle 33.75. So here you can see I have written if it is less than 51 degree 48 second. So you can also find this derivation from different books that if like they have taken this h and they have made dh by d theta equal to 0 and what is the minimum angle of inclination for which the dome will be under compression. So if the angle is less than this, then your dome will be under compression, otherwise tension will come. Okay, so for us the dome is under hoop compression. Now this alpha 33.75, so we got 19.65 kilonewton per meter. Meridional thrust means this comes in this inclined. Okay. You can refer the introduction to the water tank video to see these thrust directions. So now this thrust, you can see this is kilometer per meter square into distance, into so kilometer per meter. This is so thrust, that means force per meter run. This is next. What is the meridional stress? We have calculated here the thrust, then stress is thrust by area. So this is in kilonewton per meter. So I'm going to divide the thickness 0.1. So we got the stress. I have written here that domes are efficient as they are subjected to compressive stresses only. If we have decreased the inclination, so only compressive stresses we have. And we also have less thickness than normal circular slab cover. If it is straight circular slab, then thickness and reinforcement will be more and that may undergo under tension also. But here, because of this dome or arch action, we have less thickness. Now, so the stress is 0.196 newton per mm square. This is less than 6 newton per mm square. So it is okay. You can refer this 6 newton per mm square. I have referred Table 2 of IS 3370 Part 2 2000. In this, it is given permissible concrete stress in direct compression, because this is we have calculated for dead load, right? That is like vertical load compression. So for that direct compression for M25, I am using M25 for the design. It is given 6 newton per mm square. So it is less than this, so it is safe. So we are going to provide only minimum reinforcement as per clause 8.1. Minimum reinforcement is 0.35%. So 0.35 by 100 into thickness is 100 mm into per meter run. So 1000 I have taken as width. So 350 mm square per meter run. So the spacing will come. If I am using 8 dia bars, 143. So let's provide 8 mm dia bar at the rate of 140 mm center to center. So this will be provided radially and circumferentially. You can see if this is the elevation, and I can show you by thickness also. So these are the bars. So this in red color I've shown, these are radial bars, and circumferentially are in black color. You can see black colors. So these are the radial bar, which is straight I'm showing, and these dots are the circumferential bars. These are okay, these are the in black color. And here these are in dots. Okay. Now you see as perimeter decreases towards crown, if you see here the perimeter, because it's a dome shaped, spherical shaped, so the perimeter is decreasing. So at crown, you can see, so the spacing of radial bar decreases 0 at crown and 140 mm at springing level. This level, we say it as springing level. Okay, so here maximum thrust occurs. So here we have calculated. Here it, we should provide 140 mm, and you can just decrease the spacing to 0. Next is design of top ring beam B1. So this was the top down, then this is our ring beam. The ring beam is provided to resist the hoop tension induced by the top dome. So this is the thrust T that we have calculated, meridional thrust, and this horizontal component will be T cos alpha. So hoop tension is equal to T cos alpha into D by 2. If you see hoop stress in a pipe, we have studied. So if it is sigma is equal to forces, sigma into D by 2. So that formula only we are using. So T we have calculated above, 19.65 into cos 33.75 into diameter by 2. So we got 81.7 kilonewton. Amount of steel required is by the stress. So this stress is permissible stress in steel. I have referred table 4 of IS 3370 part 2 2009. For mild it is 150 newton per meter, as we are using Fe 415. So for high yield strength, 130 newton per mm square. Okay, 629 mm square. So I'm going to provide 5 numbers of 12 dia bars. Then coming to direct tensile stress in concrete, the force, which is 81.7 kilonewton into 10 to the 3, to convert into newton by area of concrete plus m minus 1 into area of steel. So m is the modular ratio, area of concrete plus, so modular ratio, if you see, is ES by EC, Young's modulus of steel by Young's modulus of concrete. So for steel, 2 into 10 to the 5. For this in IS 456 is given, for concrete is 5000 into root over FCK. So here we are using M25. So we got 8. 8 minus 1 into area of steel is, we have provided 5 12 dia bars. So 5 into 5 by 4, 12 square. This is equal to direct tensile stress. So permissible in table 1, if you refer for M25, it is 1.3. So we are getting area of concrete is this. So I am going to provide this provided 200 into 300. If you multiply this, this is 60,000. So it is greater than the concrete that is required. Okay, you can also change this size. So this is the beam, 200 into 300 and 5 12 dia bars. Next is design of vertical wall. So this is the vertical wall. So first we are going to calculate the hydraulic pressure. Okay, so hydraulic pressure increases at as height increases, right? So here it is 0, it is rho gh. So rho gh, hydraulic pressure is density of water is 1000 into 9.81 into this height we have calculated 2.55, right? In H3 we have calculated. So the pressure is 25015.5 newton per meter square. Now hoop tension due to hydraulic pressure is equal to P into D by 2. Just above we have done hoop stress. Here. Right. So we got 125 kilonewton per meter. How much steel required? So this in by 130 is called 962 mm square. Now I'm going to provide, so 12 dia bars at the rate of 115 mm center to center. So if you see what is the spacing, because I'm going to calculate per meter, so 1000 by I have 962 area still required by, I'm going to use 12 dia bars, so pi by 4, 12 square. So the spacing is 170, or you can say 1000 by 9. So 9 number of bars I'm using. So 1000 by 9 means 100 mm, 117 mm. So I'm just around, made it 115 mm center to center. So area of steel provided is 9 numbers we are providing into pi by 4, 12 square. So this much mm square per meter run we are providing. So for this also we are going to check the tensile stress, F by AC plus M minus 1 area of steel. So So 125077.5, this the hoop tension by area of concrete is 115 is the spacing of bar into per meter we are taking, width is 1000. So this is the area of concrete plus M, modular ratio is 8, just we have calculated above, minus 1 into area of steel provided is 1018. So I got 0.99 Newton per m square and this is less than 1.3, so it is also okay. Now calculating the vertical load, this is the vertical wall that I've shown, and we have calculated the hoop tension 12 dia at rate of 150 mm center to center. So this is how in red color I'm shown, this is how we are placing it. Now we are calculating this vertical load. For this we'll be placing this vertical strands. Okay, so vertical load is total vertical component of thrust. Okay, because this inclined thrust here, this horizontal component is like hoop tension it is producing, and the vertical component will come to this wall, that's why. So vertical component of thrust plus the dead load of all the itself wall, the ring being above it and the top dome. So vertical component is T sine alpha, T we have calculated 19.65, sine 33.75, plus dead load of wall is, wall thickness is 0.1 and height is 2.55. So this is 14.625 plus ring beam is 0.2 into 0.3 we have taken, so into 25 plus the dead load of top dome. So now this top dome total surface area I'm going to calculate into the unit width by 2 pi r of the circular water tank or the cylindrical water tank. So 25 into thickness 0.1 into 2 pi, because top dome the thickness is 100 mm, into 2 pi r into h, 2 pi r h into 20. So this is the area into 25 unit. So this much kilonewton per meter square, because this is surface area, by square 2 pi r h by the this is the perimeter of the vertical wall, 2 pi r. 2 pi r is 10 meter. I have taken the distance between the walls inside die is 10 meter, so 10 by 2. Now why this is done? Because in this case the if you see if this is the wall, you see this ring beam is exactly above the tank wall. If you see in plan, if this is the circular water tank, this vertical wall is something like circular cylindrical water tank, above this the ring beam is coming, right, exactly at this length, this perimeter, whereas this top dome, this is covering everything, right, it's not exactly coming. So what we are doing, we are adding all the load that is coming from the top dome, then we are dividing with this perimeter, because only this perimeter is going to take that load. In case of ring beam, it is already exactly in the perimeter. Even if I multiply the its length, then I have to divide with the same length, right? That's why. Now we got the total load. Then stress is equal to this load by 100 mm thickness we got, and this is less than 6 Newton per mm square. This is also okay. So we are going to provide the minimum steel 0.35%. So 0.35% of thickness is 100. Per meter, so 350 mm square. I'm going to provide 8 mm dia bar at the rate of 140 mm center to center each face. So this face also and this face also. Next is design of bottom dome. Bottom, our rise is 1.2 meter. For them, for that the radius is calculating using same arc equation 11.02 meter and sine theta. If this is 2 theta angle, I'm taking this half of this triangle, sine theta is this 5 by the radius, 5 by 11.02, 27 degree. This is less than 51 degree 48 second. So the dome is under hoop compression only. So first, what is the dead load of dome? 25, thickness we have taken 100 mm, so 2.5 kN per meter square. load intensity due to water, because above this water is there. So this is weight of water divided by the surface area of the dome. That will be the load intensity. So weight of water will be volume into density into G, VDG by surface area 2 pi RH. Okay. So volume of this will be, so I have taken same formula we have used while calculating the size of the or the capacity of tank, right? That means the total volume of the cylinder minus we have to do this area, the area of the volume of the bottom dome. That is which will give the volume of water. So V1 minus V2, here I have calculated where V1 is volume cylinder, okay, and V2 is volume bottom dome. So using getting this volume V1 minus V2 into density of water is 1000 into G is 9.81 by 2 pi R and H is 1.2. We got 17.5 kilonewton per meter square. So total load is the dead load plus this load due to water. We got 20 kilonewton per meter square. Then meridional thrust is WR2 by 1 plus cos theta formula. Weight, so load is 20 into R is 11.02, 1 plus cos 27 degree. So here theta we have calculated 27 degree under 16.55 kilonewton per meter. Now the stress is by thickness. So we got 1165 kilonewton per meter square. This is 1.165 newton per m square. This is less than 6. So this is also okay. And we are going to provide minimum steel 0.35%. So 8 mm dia bar at the rate of 140 mm center to center. Now, so this is the last part of design of bottom ring beam B2. So I have assumed in, at start like 250 into 300 mm. So dead load of the vertical wall, then top dome, bottom dome, top ring beam plus bottom ring beam. So for vertical wall, 25 into 0.1 into 2.55. In case of this dome, both the domes, so total surface area into unit weight by the 2 pi r, this bottom ring beam, the perimeter. Okay. So we have finally got 23.112 kilonewton per meter. So this is the dead load. Now hydraulic pressure is again VDG by 2 pi r, same volume density G that we have calculated above by 2 pi r, r is here 5 meter for this ring beam. Because the ring beam is around this cylindrical water tank, which is of diameter 10 meter. So, divide by 2 is 5. 46.2. So, total load is dead load plus hydraulic pressure. We got 69.3 kilonewton per meter. Now, this ring beam is going to be designed as circular beam. So, let us assume that it has been supported by some 6 columns. So, this is the ring beam around under this vertical cylindrical tank, and it has been supported by some 6 columns, okay, which are of diameter some 300 mm. Now if you refer any circular beam design, so it is same, you can refer in any standard books. So in that, what we have to do is we have to refer some coefficients for maximum moment. If number, it depends on number of supports. If there are 4 columns or 6 columns or 8 columns, since we have 6 columns, we are going to refer for these values. So this is 2 alpha is 60 degree. Then these are the coefficients which we will be using in the design. Okay. So if I am taking this a section and this is the center O, so there will be a moment. There will be a vertical shear. This is the thickness of the ring beam if I am taking. This is the shear and the torsion. Okay. So the formula for the moments for circular beam is sagging moment at midspan is 2 WR square alpha lambda. Walking moment is minus 2 WR square alpha lambda dash. So these are different coefficients. For torsion is 2 WR square alpha lambda double dash. So this is common 2 WR square alpha. This I have calculated 2 W total load. We have calculated 69.3 into alpha is the distance, center to center distance I've taken. That means 10 by 2 is total diameter 10 by 2 meter. And because I have assumed the ring beam to be 250 mm, so 250 mm by 2, or in meter 0.25 by 2, 5.125. And this is pi by 3 is alpha. Alpha means there are total angle of a circle is 360 degree. There are six columns, so the angle between two columns or a span, one span will be 60 degree. So in converting to this to radian is pi by 3. So we got 3812.23. So 3812.23 into the coefficients. This coefficients we have taken from here. For six columns, there's 0.045, 0.089, 0.009. So calculating this, we have calculated the moments and the torsion values. So first, let's assume what will be the D value. So I'm just taking 0.13 to FCK BD square is equal to moment, which is I've taken the maximum moment between these two, 339.29 × 10⁶, to convert into Newton mm into 1.5 as safety factor. So D has come almost like 545 mm when I'm assuming B as 450 mm. I'm using M25, so I'm putting 25 here, 450 here, so D will come 545 around. So the total depth I can take is 600 mm with some cover, that's why. Now, because we have torsion also, the equivalent moment will be M plus torsion into 1 plus D by B by 1.7. This D is not the diameter, but the depth of the beam. So this formula you can refer IS 456 in page 86, it is given. When you have torsion and moment, the equivalent moment formula. So moment is 339, the maximum value, plus 34.31 is the torsion value. So 0.6 the depth taken by the width is 0.45 by 1.7. So we got 386.4 kilometer meter. Now for longitudinal reinforcement, I have used this. How much area still is required if we are designing as under reinforcement. In under reinforced beam, so 1.5 safety factor into M equivalent, which is 386.4 into 10⁶, is equal to 0.87. I'm using Fe 415 into 415 area still. So D minus 0.87 Fy, it has still by 0.36 F. FCK is 25 into 450. So while solving, when I'm using this depth, which we have assumed as 545, it is coming error because this is not enough to provide steel. So I've increased the depth D as 900 mm and total depth, overall depth as 950 mm. So our size of ring bottom ring beam is 450 to 950. And once you put this value here, small d as 950 as 900, so you're going to get steel as 2312 mm square, which is greater than minimum area steel provided, which is 0.85 BD by FY formula as for beam. So for 2312 mm square, I'm going to provide six numbers of 22 mm dia bars. Okay. So now as the depth has been more than 450 mm, so we are going to provide 0.1% of steel along vertical sides. Okay. So this is 622 dia bar, 336, 22 dia bar, and this four bars of 12 dia in the vertical sides. So 0.1 into 100, 450 into 900, 405 mm square, so 412 dia bar. The vertical size, and this two again extra two die bar so that we can provide stirrups to hold the stirrups. So for calculation of stirrups, transfer steel, area of steel percent is how much we have. We used 6 into 4 by 4 pi by 4 into 12 22 square by the BD into 100, 0.56%. So for this, if you refer table 23 in IS 456, your concrete strength, shear strength is 0.31 newton per mm square. Now coming to our shear force is how much load has come into span by 2 into number of columns. Okay, because 2 supports, so 2, how many columns are there? So 69.3 into the span is 2 pi into 5 by now 2 by number of columns, 6 columns we have used. So 181.4 kilonewton is your shear force. Now referring IS 456 again, can see your shear stress formula will be, if torsion is there, V plus 1.6 D by B by BD. So this 181.4, we have calculated shear force plus 1.6, torsion is 34.3 by B is 450, by BD 450 into 900. So 0.45 newton per mm square. So what is the shear reinforcement? This also you can refer IS 456. The area of transverse steel in this annexure B 6.4.3. The torsion into spacing SV by B1 D1 into sigma SV permissible stress into V into SV by 2.5 D1 again permissible strength. So area of steel, if I'm providing two legged 10 mm dia bars, so 2 into pi by 4 10 square is equal to torsion we have calculated, shear force we have calculated, this spacing I have just taken out of the bracket by B1 D1, so and sigma SV also I have taken outside, which is 0.87 FY. Now B1 D1 is, if I am taking a 30 mm cover from top and bottom, the width will be 450 minus 30 into 2 390 mm, D1 will be 950 minus 30 into 260, so 890 mm. This is what B1 D1 into 2.5 into 890. So we have calculated spacing is 695 mm, which is less than your minimum spacing that is required by as per the code, that is tau VE minus tau C is sigma SV into B into SV. This is the formula. So if I'm providing 10 dia bars, so I'm getting minimum as 900 mm. But tau V and tau C we have calculated here. Tau V and tau C. So once you put the values, you get that minimum spacing. So anyhow, we are providing 695, which is lesser than 900 mm. So these are the stirrups that you have to provide at the spacing of 695 mm. So this ends the design. Thank you for watching.